I'm Deputy Chief Reginald Winston. On behalf of Chief Mark McCrory and our entire staff, I welcome y'all to the Casa Grande Police Department. We truly appreciate all of you joining our family to remember our fallen brother, Tate Lynch. After our short service, we ask you to stay as long as you want to meet Tate's family and share your memories. At this time, please join me in standing as we lower our flags in honor of this occasion.
Father, once again, we come to remember Tate Lynch. Remember his boyish demeanor, the smile that filled the room. Remember his enthusiasm, energetic leadership that placed him in the middle of every action. We remember that he was always involved. His team could not forget the fact that he was always their leader. We remember that he was a caring and compassionate person. We thank you for his sincere expression of his faith. And while he was a respecter of others, he was clear in his commitment to his Lord. We thank you for the scripture that he left behind. Haven't I commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Father, thanks for the memory. Amen.
You may be seated. Thank you so much, Chaplain. Thank you to the Casa Grande Police Honor Guard. And thank you all very much for joining us tonight. We have a special guest speaker with us tonight, but before I ask him to step up here, I thought I'd give a few of you a little bit of information, a little bit of background of Tate and our agency, by way of our Spirit of Service Award that we hand out as an award during our annual dinner. And I'll just read it directly from that award listing. Tate began his law enforcement career with the city of Holbrook. He worked there for 2 years before moving to Casa Grande. During his 7 years at CGPD, Tate served our department as a field training officer and ultimately as a patrol sergeant. Tate was also a member of the Pinal Regional SWAT team. He believed in staying physically fit. It was common to see him running the streets of Rancho Grande for exercise. This running wasn't all lost on physical conditioning. He spent most of his nights on duty running as well. He ran from one call to another, chasing down bad guys. Because you see, that's what Tate really liked to do, chase the bad guys and catch them. He was good at it. He was a family man, and a man of God. He married a wonderful young woman, Christy, and had three beautiful children, Kayla, Sam, and Alyssa. Tate was very involved at his church, and many of his friendships were cultivated there. Tate touched people in many different ways, as a friend, a mentor, a confidant, and as a servant. He struck me as the kind of person who wanted to live his life to the fullest, leaving nothing behind. Something that each of us as humans, as public servants, can only hope for. But he did leave something behind. He left his legacy. That is the passage from our Spirit of Service Award. At this time, I'd like to ask Tate's father, Gary Lynch, to come and say a few words. Gary?
Good evening. Thank you very much for coming tonight. The family appreciates you being here. I would like to also thank the Casa Grande Police Department for this memorial service and for Officer Thomas Anderson's work put it together. I want to again thank you. It is an honor and a privilege to be here to spend just a few moments talking with you. I had the privilege of being a Tucson police officer for over 37 years. I would like to talk to you a little bit about Tate, tell you a little bit about him. When I was going to the police academy, Tate was going to be born. He was our first child, first son to be born sometime during the police academy. And I came home and I told Diana, my wife, I said, Diana, I don't know what I'm going to do. Our sergeant at the academy keeps coming in and telling us, you don't miss academy time for any reason. It doesn't matter the reason you don't miss it. What are we going to do? I was looking at my wife, was very soon to deliver our son. She, of course, was no longer working. I had quit the job that I had been working at, now going to the academy, and we had just purchased our home. So I didn't know what to do. You know, I wasn't wise enough at that time, smart enough to know that the Tucson Police Department would have allowed me to go and be at the birth of my son, be with my wife. But I have to tell you, with Tate being the considerate, thoughtful, loving son he was born on a Saturday afternoon. So I didn't have to worry about missing time. As Tate grew, he would walk around the house with the shirt tails of my academy recruit shirt dragging on the floor, wearing my 8-point uniform hat. He'd walk all over, and he did this for a very long time. I should have known then that there was a future in law enforcement for him, but he really enjoyed doing that. Tate, at a very young age, started riding with me as an observer in my police car. He probably rode 120 times with me. As we would go to a call, I'd say, Tate, look at the computer. Look at what they're telling us is happening at this moment. What should we do? Or, if I'd gone to a call, handled it in one way, I'd say, what do you think about what I did? Could I have done something different? And it was surprising how much he could give me information-wise that was good information. Our family attended a church, and there was another family that attended a church, and they had a daughter. I was home one day, and Tate came home. He walked through the door, and he had this starry, glazed look on his face. And he said, Dad, I met a girl. You did? What's her name? He was sitting then on the couch, he put both hands up behind his head, leaned back, and he said, Christy! His whole voice changed. That began a love for this girl, this young woman, this woman, that never ended. He loved her, he loved his family, Kayla, Samuel, and Alyssa. He loved God. He said that he wanted to go into law enforcement, that that was what he wanted to do. We had a friend in the church that we were attending, and the friend said, I'm going to work in Holbrook. Why don't you come? I know the chief of police. Talk with him. see if their position's open for you. He went up, talked with the chief of police. He said, once you go to the academy, you can come here and you'll have a job. Well, Tate went to Holbrook. Now, Holbrook was quite different than what he had seen at the Tucson Police Department. Much quieter, a very small department, but Tate stayed very busy. He always stayed busy. There were times on the midnight shift that he was the only officer working, and they would call the Department of Public Safety to assist if they needed someone, hoping that they would be close around to help him. But he worked there, enjoyed the job, and then he said, hey, Dad, I'm going to the Casa Grande Police Department and apply for a position there. He called back later and he said, I'm going to go to work. I got hired. He said, I'm so excited. He said, I'm going to the big city. He said, I'm going to a big department. I'm so excited. Well, he came and he really loved the job. He loved the officers. He loved the command staff. He liked working in this city and enjoyed it so very, very much. He stayed very, very busy. A tribute to that was on a couple of occasions I rode with him, and he'd be flagged down by one of the officers as he would leave the station, and the officer said, Tate, I'm coming on duty in just a few minutes. Don't get involved in anything until I come out, because I want to be with you when you do it. Because he was always, always busy. He became a sergeant. He and Christy worked together, putting their presentation together so that he could show it to the oral board. He was selected as a sergeant, and then later he applied to the SWAT team. He called me and he said, hey, Dad, I'm going to be a SWAT officer. I got a return call. He said, I've got my uniform. You ought to see this uniform. It is great, and I've got my SWAT rifle. You've got to come and shoot it. You've got to shoot it. And I said, yes, I would like that. I've never shot a SWAT rifle. Oh, I would enjoy that. He said, well, come up. Well, I went up. He said, I've got the range. I've been given the authority to shoot this gun, and I want you to shoot it. He said, let's go out to the range. So he set the targets up. He said, now, I've only got a limited amount of ammunition, but you're going to enjoy it. You're going to really have a good time. So he takes the rifle. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. That's all the ammunition. And he turns and he says, wasn't that fun? Yes, Tate, it certainly wasn't. I still haven't shot a SWAT rifle. He was so excited, so very excited. You know, being a new sergeant, he would often call me and ask me questions. And one evening, he called. It was about 1 o'clock in the morning. I was en route home from my swing shift. I answered the telephone and he said, oh, thank God. He said, this is what's happening. He said, there's another supervisor with another agency that has said I can't do what I'm thinking of doing. I said, well, tell me what it is you're doing. He told me about the circumstances, told me what he wanted to do, and I said, what you're doing sounds good to me. It sounds really good. And then I heard something in the background, and I said, is there someone else in the car with you? He said, yes, another supervisor. And I thought, you know, he wasn't embarrassed. It's calling me, asking me questions. His father, a patrolman, he wasn't the least bit embarrassed over that. He enjoyed doing that, and I enjoyed being able to answer questions for him. You know, he liked this city. He loved working here. He loved the officers that he worked with. I think if he would not have passed away, he would be here still today. And it would be like me at the police department, having spent 37 years. I thought after a while they were just going to lock the door and push me out because I would never go away. And I think that's the way it is with Tate. If he would have been here today, he would have still been working because he loved his family. He loved this city. He loved this department. They spoke earlier about compassion. Tate had compassion for the people that he dealt with, the people he would go and have a call with, and the arrestees. He would have compassion on them. Tate did love God. One of his favorite verses has been quoted already in Joshua chapter 1, verse 9. Have I not commanded you, be strong, be brave, Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God loves you, and the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. And I just again want to thank you very much for being here tonight. It is an honor to be able to speak to you, and thank you.
Thank you very much, Gary. Some of our explorers have been handing out these candle lights, and there's a little button at the bottom. Gary, thank you. You're a very humble person. He didn't mention that he's probably one of the most highly decorated police officers the city of Tucson has ever seen. And for that, we are very appreciative of your service, sir. Thank you very much for speaking to us tonight as well. So I think it was a couple of years ago, and by the way, won't be a much longer service. We typically keep the service very short, and we'll stay true to that as usual. But a couple of years ago, I believe it was Alyssa that asked about us releasing some balloons, and we did. And by the way, Alyssa and Sam are here tonight, but Kayla, of course, is out, you know, all over the world as she usually is these days. So we had these lights, and I thought that'd be a neat surprise for Alyssa and Sam. But then Alyssa said she wanted to bring us a video to play that she made. So to end the service tonight, I'd like to show this video that Alyssa made, share it with you. And when that's over, we'll conclude our ceremony. And as Deputy Chief Winston said at the beginning, please stay and socialize and hang out with us a little bit. We even have some food for you because we know we have you here at dinner time. So please enjoy.
Still here somehow, but I'll let you go. Now.
Yes, clap, please. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining our family as we remember Tate tonight.